X103.9, the IE's alternative just rock, walk the moon and a sun. 7 or 9:29 on the station, always giving you the best new music. Speaking of, very happy to have special guests in the studio this morning. Guys from the Neighbourhood are here. I've got Zach, Jeremy, and Jesse hanging on the studio. Guys, thank you so much for being here.
What's up, man? How you doing?
Doing great. This is like, now, you know, with the bands, new bands coming in here and playing, this is like the new music breakthrough show. This is it for you guys, in case you didn't know. This is the moment from which it all changes now, having been here in the morning at X1039 with me. They're so impressed, they can barely speak right now. Guys, the Neighbourhood. All right, now, first thing I want to say to you guys is, I'm very happy that you guys spell your name with a U in like the classic European spelling of Neighbourhood, because otherwise you would be the hardest band to find information with on a Google search.
Yeah, it'd be tough, man.
Is that why you did it?
No, I mean, the other one was taken, but I mean, it's kind of a good thing. I think this way it looks better anyway.
Yeah, there's some other posers out there with a name similar to yours. I would get the lawyers on that.
Yeah, no, we're working on it.
All right, now the Neighbourhood, now you guys, first thing I want to get to, you are not an L.A. band. You guys are from SoCal, but you are not from L.A., and that's an important distinction.
Yeah, we're from Newbury Park, right around the area, at least in Newbury Park. Like, a couple of us are from Newbury, and a couple of us are from like other surrounding areas. But
so if you had come on here and I just said, L.A. band, the Neighbourhood, would you have corrected me right away, Jesse?
No, I mean, I guess it's just so much easier for people to say that, but I mean, when you get in depth, yeah, like if you were to ask, so you guys are from L.A.? We'd say, no, not necessarily.
Well, I guess if you were in Boston or something, but of course here in the Inland Empire, everyone here is very sensitive to the fact that we all live in Southern California, but this ain't L.A.
Yeah.
Just like if they were from Orange, from the O.C., you'd be saying, no, they're not from the O.C.
Yeah,
right? Are you guys all buddies? Did you grow up together, or did you just meet once you started playing in bands?
Yeah, we're... Before we started doing music together, we were really good friends for a really long time. Like, me and Mikey, who's not here right now, have been friends for like 13 years, like childhood friends. Me and Jeremy went to the same elementary school, and Jesse just came along when we were there.
Okay, and was that a thing you had talked
about? 5 years ago, probably.
Was that something you had talked about when you were kids? We were, oh, we're gonna be in a band together one day, dude, it's gonna be great.
I mean, we just wanted to play music one day, and we started doing it, and it was cool, but up until like a year and a half ago, that's when like things really started to click.
All right, now I know you guys, like many bands when you first start out, you know, grab guys from a couple of other bands you know. What is that like when you steal someone away from another band, especially, you know, young bands trying to come up?
We've never really done that. We never really stole anybody away. We were in separate bands when we were younger, but then all the bands broke up, and then we like were just buddies and...
Okay, good. So you didn't ruin another potential band on the way up.
No. Actually, we almost did. Early on, there was two other dudes that were playing bass and drums with us, and we actually ended up not playing with them and getting two other guys that weren't in bands, because those two guys were in bands together. So, but I mean, yeah, I guess.
You guys have only been together for, like I said, just about a year and a half now, but already getting a lot of notice. You're getting some nice critical praise. What was your first break? Like, of somebody significant noticing your band and going, hey, you guys are good.
When Zane Lowe premiered us on BBC Radio 1.
What's that?
When Zane Lowe premiered us on BBC Radio 1.
BBC Radio 1? That's a nice break. Were you guys nervous?
More excited.
Yeah, it's exciting, yeah. I don't think we get too nervous about things usually. At least I don't, speaking for myself. I think we just get more anxious is a better word, and I don't know. There's so many big moments for us that have happened in the past year. Like, it's like the first year of our lives. It's pretty cool.
And of course, you guys just got back from the South by Southwest show, which had to be a lot of fun, I don't know. Other than the fact that apparently some other band got you guys sick.
I think like every band there probably got sick. We're torn up right now, man. It's like, it's tough.
You guys are gamers. I was just telling you about Michael Jordan having his best performance ever with the flu. You guys are going to play in just a little bit.
No 23, man. We'll see.
What's very important, like right off the bat, that people always try to do with any new band is immediately classify you. And every band hates this, but to a certain extent, what people want to know, I mean, you guys definitely have a lot of different styles creatively coming together from the band. What do you guys call your style if you had to do it, which you have to, since I just asked you?
I would say just dark pop.
Dark pop. I've never heard that one before. I like it.
It's an easy way to describe it, you know?
And are you guys very different with what you guys like personally in music? Are there really contrasting styles, or are you guys in a similar mindset on what you like?
I think we all have a similar mindset, but as far as what we listen to, it's very different.
We have a similar mindset as to what the neighborhood is and like what we want to write for the neighborhood, but it comes in from what all of our own brains like to take in aside from the neighborhood, like musically or whatever. Like, yeah, the three of us had written like all the songs that people have heard so far, like all the EP and everything. The album was a little bit more of a collaborative effort with the other two dudes in the band, but...
Yeah, your new CD is coming out April the 21st.
23rd.
Or 23rd, excuse me. New CD, I Love You.
Correct.
Nice title for a first CD.
Yeah.
I like it.
Is that very personal?
No, I just think it's really meaningless. So.
Great point, just throw it out there. I Love You.
Yeah.
You guys are going to be playing Coachella coming up. Obviously, a gigantic show. Is that something, obviously, well, of course you're looking forward to it, but I mean, I don't know. Does that make you nervous when you're going to be around other gigantic artists and now you sit there and think, we're one of those bands, dude?
No, again, it's not really a nervous thing. I'm excited to be around that environment. That's where like, I feel that we belong. I think it makes a lot of sense to me, so.
That's cool. I'm glad you didn't say, well, aw, shucks, you know, gee, we just hope about... What do you want for the band? What are your aspirations for this band? If everything comes out just the way you want, what do you want to have happen by next year?
I mean, we wanted all this to happen this year. Like, the first goal we set out for was Coachella. Like, that was the first thing that we, like, sat down, we're like...
Oh, that's cool.
First, like, reachable, like, actual physical goal, like, that was it. There's, like, an umbrella goal of, you know, getting signed and, like, having people enjoy our music and, you know, getting bigger and bigger and bigger and buzzing and all that kind of stuff. And that's all happened, you know, and all those goals are coming true. But, like, Coachella was the first one that was really, you know, the definite, like, I want to get from A to B, and that's B.
And how do you first find out that you're going to be on Coachella? How do you get that news?
I think they're booking it. Call their manager, and their manager called us.
Yeah.
And did they say, you're going to be at Coachella, or did they say, hey, guys, would you like to be at Coachella this year?
No, I think they asked.
They're
like, so should I confirm?
And
we're like,
yes. No way, dude. Our manager called us because he knew that we were wanted. That was like the first thing we did, like when we were taking label meetings or anything early on, was like, hey, we really want to play Coachella. That was like our thing. So Kirk called us and was like, hey, guys, what do you think about being at Coachella this year? And we were like, no way.
No, yeah, I know, but like. I think
Already we have friction among the band. You know, I hope this isn't going to lead to any problems down the road. Guys, once again, we're hanging out with The Neighbourhood. We've been playing their new CD, or their new song, Sweater Weather, off the I'm Sorry EP. Guys, I could sit there and ask you all day, how would you classify your music? It's a lot easier for you guys just to play it. You guys ready to go?
Yeah, we'll play Sweater Weather for you.
All right. It's The Neighbourhood with Sweater Weather on X103.9.
And all I am is a man. I want this world in my hands. I hate the beach, but I stand in California with my toes in the sand. Grab the sleeves of my sweater, let's have an adventure. Heads in the clouds, but my gravity center. Touch my neck, I'll touch yours. You and those little high-waisted shorts. Oh, she knows what I think about. And what I think about, one love, two mouths. One love, one house. No shirt, no blouse. Just us, and you find out nothing, nothing. Cause it's too cold, for you here and now. Let me hold both your hands in those. And if I may, just take your breath away. I don't mind if there's not much to say. Sometimes the silence guards our minds to a place so far away. The goosebumps start to raise the minute that my left hand meets your waist. And then I watch your face, put my finger on your tongue cause you love the taste. And these hearts adore everyone the other beats hardest for. Inside this place is warm, outside it starts to pour. Coming down, one love, two one else, no shirt, no blouse, just us, and you find out nothing that we don't want to tell you about, no, 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 cause it's too cold for you here and now, so let me hold both your hands in, cause it's too cold.
X103.9, The Neighborhood, and Sweater Weather. And Jesse, Nigel, you pulled it. You reached deep. You got through that sore throat. You did it, man.
I'm trying my best.
It was a hell of a performance. It was a Michael Jordan-worthy performance. Once again, The Neighborhood. What is the easiest place on the internet to find out everything that you guys are doing?
Go visit us at our website.
THENBHD.com. Thanks for making it easy, guys. Once again, The Neighborhood, guys. Thanks a lot for coming and hanging out with us, and the best of luck in this year for everything for you guys.
Thank you, man. Thanks for having us, guys.
941, Social Distortion on the X.